Okay, well, this leads us on to an idea we've had. It's the Top Gear Down to Earth board. You see, the problem is we get a lot of criticisms from viewers who say that we spend far too much time talking about Zondas and Ferraris and Aston Martins and not enough time giving advice, you know, sensible buying advice to people in cardigans. So, what we've got here are all the small cars. There's the little Smart, there's the Mitsubishi Colt on which it's based. And now we've driven all of these, and we think that if you're going to buy such a thing, go for either the Honda Jazz or the Toyota Yaris. Those are the two, OK? Right, now, Aston Martin. OK, it's time now for the Top Gear Down to Earth board, an idea we introduced last week to provide an island of sanity in the usual Top Gear world of testosterone and tyre smoke. We did small cars last week, and we said the two best were the Toyota Yaris and the Honda Jazz. That was for people with cardigans. Now, this week, on the Down to Earth board, it's cars for people whose kids are at private school. Why not? Obviously, you need to have a lot of space for the stereo and the trunks and so on, but the most crucial thing is, vital, don't buy a flash car. Really, you know? You're just going to get bullied. We've driven all of them, and we think two best, Land Rover Discovery and Subaru Legacy. Spec B.
Now, we've got one here, innit? And for that reason, we have over here the Top Gear Down to Earth board. Now, we use this, well, we used it once, actually, to sort the wheat from the chaff, and we're trying to determine which of a particular segment of the market, which cars we would actually buy if it were our own money. So we've got, what have we got here? We've got the Primera.
No,
not really. The Peugeot looks good.
Looks very good, but no, it'll fall to pieces, made by people who eat onions. Vauxhall Vectra. Anyone got one? Who says you have? Andy, you're a big chap. It's
yes,
a nice car.
It. good choice, sir.
I may have been wrong about that earlier. Which one would you have? Which one would you steal? It's not like a car thief, is it? Anyone under 25 is a car thief in my book. Jaguar,
yeah,
you'd have the Passat.
Right. It's a quality car, though. It's for the money. 16.
So you'd have I'd have that one, the Mazda 6, because it's very good value for money. Okay, it won't go wrong. It looks very good, and it's fantastic to drive.
It is a very good car. I do like that. I like the Laguna, but
safe car.
But I'd also like the Saab. But
Jaguar?
No.
You've got
the Merc C-Class problem. No, I would have the new VW Passat. Drove this recently. It's a good car to drive. Slightly more expensive than that, but not by much. And it's got a quality feel.
That girl behind you, taller than you.
She is taller than me. I'm aware of this.
Keep talking.
I haven't even turned around. I know she's taller
than me. She's come out in her nighty, which is quite funny.
You are wearing your pyjamas.
Yeah, I'm wearing my pyjamas. Don't be embarrassed. Anyway, a Top Gear top tip there. If you want the best car in the class, you buy the BMW 3 Series. If you want to be perceived as a human being, get one of those.
Right, now, which is why we find ourselves back at the Top Gear Down to Earth board. Now, these are all the cars in our price bracket of the sort we're looking at, around £30,000.
Absolutely, and the one you want, without a shadow of a doubt, is the new Porsche Boxster.
No, because at this price range, you're going to have the 2.7 litre.
That doesn't move.
It's got no power.
It doesn't move. It's a Porsche.
No, the idea is it's not about absolute performance, it's about the balance and the feel.
Oh,
that is the perfect sports car.
Sorry, quite clearly what you want is the BMW M4. There it is.
You know, when that first came out, I thought it was ugly. But you see quite a few of them around now, and I reckon it's quite a good-looking car, that.
See? I knew you'd come round in the end.
I haven't come round. I've got enough back problems without driving a car with that ride. So I'd have the Honda S2000.
This is ridiculous, because we couldn't come to a verdict when we were in Iceland. Now we've come back, we've got three completely different cars, and we still haven't got a verdict.
I think we have got a verdict, because the three cars we took to Iceland all started out as coupes and then had the roofs cut off to make them convertibles. Those three were all designed to be two-seater.
From the start.
Exactly. So although we can't agree on which car we'd have, we can give you a Top Gear top tip, and that's if you want a two-seater convertible, buy one that was designed to be a two-seater convertible.
Yes.
And on that bombshell, it's time to end. Thank you very much for watching. See you again next week. Good night.